There are more than a billion planets in the universe, at least one for every star in the galaxy. But some of these bodies look nothing like Mother Earth, and nothing lives in them, not even aliens. Some are so terrifying that scientists gave them nicknames to describe their horrifying nature, like the hellish planet. Since the first exoplanets were discovered in the 1990s, scientists have found planets with extreme temperatures, covered in molten seas, some filled with water or ice, and planets as light as styrofoam. NASA, aided by technology, has discovered 4,401 exoplanets far beyond our solar system. The universe is infinitely vast, bigger than we have ever imagined. Even with the advancement in technology, scientists have yet to find an explanation for some of the creepiest things going on in space, like why the Milky Way is moving too fast. But space exploration has revealed that Earth may just be the nicest place to live. From those that burn in thousands of degrees heat to those full of nothing but radiation or covered in acid rain, not to mention planets like Pluto with temperatures far below ice point, and the list goes on and on. What the hell happened to our universe after the Big Bang? Why are some planets so different? Think our world is scary? Hold on to your seat, because space exploration has taken us to some of the most terrifying planets beyond the Milky Way. TRES-2b. 750 light-years away from the solar system, in the Draco constellation, lies a planet called TRES-2b. The planet itself is about 1.49 times as massive as Jupiter, one of the largest planets in the solar system, but orbits extremely close to its host star, the GSC 03549-02811. Despite all that heat energy being dumped into it, TRES-2b doesn't glow visibly. It is so dark that the darkest objects you can imagine will seem like a star beside it. Astronomers believe that TRES-2b's atmosphere contains lots of sodium, potassium, or gaseous titanium oxide. These gases eat up the light without giving out any rays. As if that wasn't terrifying enough, TRES-2b is boiling at over 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit, hot enough to melt metals like tungsten and tin. There is no chance of life existing or surviving on this planet. If the gases don't get you, the heat definitely will. Poltergeist. Fukushima in Japan may be the most radioactive place on Earth, but Poltergeist is a clear winner in the exoplanets. Named after the ghost character from Steven Spielberg's 1982 film, Poltergeist is the first exoplanet discovered and has a mass four times bigger than Earth's. It is found approximately 2,300 light-years away in the constellation of Virgo, orbiting around the dense core of a massive, fast-rotating exploded star called a neutron star. It has an orbital time frame of 25.3 days, and with each orbit, showers or blasts of radiation flow from the star into the planet's atmosphere. The radiation is so intense, it can be detected from Earth. Poltergeist is unwelcoming and may never let anything walk on its surface. WASP-12b. WASP-12b is another planet at the mercy of its parent star. At 4,000 degrees Fahrenheit, this planet is so hot that it melts anything that comes into contact with its surface. The iron and magnesium deposits have long become gases filling up the atmosphere. Its parent star does more than heat this exoplanet, but is also devouring pieces of WASP-12b to assemble itself into the shiniest object in the universe. The extreme gravity is stretching the hot gas giant, giving it the shape of the American football. Soon, WASP-12b will be completely swallowed up by its hungry star. WASP-12b is clear proof that gravity may be more dangerous than we've ever thought. KELT-9b. Our Earth's sun is so hot that a typical summer afternoon can cause heat spells. Now imagine a planet 136 times that of the Earth. KELT-9b has a killer temperature of 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit and is known as the hottest planet. The heat of KELT-9b is so intense that molecules of hydrogen gas on the day side of the tidally locked KELT-9b are likely blasted apart, unable to reform until their fragmented atoms travel around to the planet's night side. K KELT-9b sees the complete range of stellar temperatures twice every orbit, giving it an interesting seasonal pattern. When the planet swings over each hot pole, it experiences summer, and when it passes over the star's colder center, it experiences winter. Astronomers speculate that the KELT-9b star might swallow it up within 200 years as it grows. Venus. Earth's sister isn't as friendly as it should be. Instead, it boils at 900 degrees Fahrenheit and rains acid in place of water. Its sulfur-rich atmosphere ensures that no sunlight penetrates the planet's surface and prevents carbon dioxide from escaping. The thick carbon dioxide atmosphere traps heat, making it hot enough to melt lead and spawn vast volcanoes. Scientists believe Venus could have been a habitable planet had it not been for a runaway greenhouse effect. The planet got too close to the inner edge of the Sun's habitable zone and got exposed to intense radiation. Over the millions and billions of years, its oceans dried up and global warming set in. Now, Venus is nothing but an ocean of boiling sulfuric acid. Koro-T7b. In the constellation of Monceros, 489 light-years from Earth, scientists discovered Koro-T7b. Until the announcement of Kepler-10b in 2011, it was the smallest exoplanet to have its diameter measured, at 1.58 times that of the Earth, and the first potential extrasolar terrestrial planet to be found. Koro-T7b has the style of the planet Saturn with a rocky nature, reasons astronomers first thought that it might support life. But they were so wrong. Not only can the Koro-T7b not support life, but it would also be impossible to live there. Its atmosphere comprises minerals that turn into rock clouds that fall as pebbles and rocks. During the daytime, this exoplanet becomes tidally locked into its star, raising temperatures to 3,600 degrees Fahrenheit. HD 189733b. This planet was nicknamed Blue Planet, but don't let the cute nickname fool you into thinking of beaches and sunset. Its clouds are super rich in silica, which causes lung cancer. But silica clouds are not the only thing that makes this planet deadly. HD 189733b's deadly wind sweeps as fast as 8,700 kilometers per hour, seven times the speed of light. You can compare its wind speed to Hurricane Katrina, blowing at 175 miles per hour. If anything got into its path, it'll meet immediate destruction. Let's not forget the molten glass rains. Yes, it rains glass on HD 189733b. The combination of silica rain, scorching heat, and horrendous winds makes HD 189733b one of the most terrifying planets in the universe. GJ-436b. GJ-436b is a small rocky exoplanet orbiting in the habitable zone of the star GJ-436, which is about 33 light-years from Earth. It was previously thought to be filled with hot ice in different strange high-pressure forms that would remain solid despite the high temperatures due to the planet's gravity and the 822 degree Fahrenheit, too cold to melt its ice. But further research revealed its surface is mostly hydrogen and helium gases. HD 8060b. If hell were a planet, it would be HD 8060b. True to its name, the hellish planet has an insanely high temperature of 930 degrees Fahrenheit, but can increase to 2190 degrees Fahrenheit or more. Not only is HD 8060b hellish, its surface spells doom as if to say, you're not welcome here. The daytime is one of many hot times on HD 8060b planet, but that doesn't make the nighttime cooler. The nights are hotter than molten lava, resulting from a hot spot on the planet. There are theories that the hot spot results from heavy winds around the planet in a direction away from the star, which sends shocks that increase the heat of the planet's atmosphere. Jupiter. Jupiter is more than 300 times larger than Earth and twice the size of all the other planets in our solar system combined. The planet is so large that if it were in the center of the solar system, it would extend past the asteroid belt and into the region where Mars orbits. Besides that, Jupiter is made almost entirely of helium and hydrogen gas, hence it has no surface for an object or human to stand on. The gas giant also holds more than twice as much water as Earth does, and all of it is frozen solid under the crushing pressure of Jupiter's atmosphere. With a surface temperature of minus 238 degrees Fahrenheit, Jupiter can freeze any life form that dares intrude on its privacy. Its gravity is only twice that of the Earth, not enough to kill, but the intense pressure inside could crush a human to death in seconds.